It's the Sneak Aficionado Solution, back with another video. Told y'all I was behind, so gotta get caught up due to my weekend festivities. Had a lot going on, so let's get on with it. First, I'm gonna talk about one of the perks of living in the part of the country that I now reside in. I'm originally from Baltimore. And like Baltimore, San Antonio has a lot of outlets within the area. Like Baltimore has Lancaster, Arundel Mills, and Potomac Mills. Within an hour or two of all of those, you can get to all of those outlets. You know, so you're a big Nike outlet sneaker guy, you can hit those up. Well, here in San Antonio, you hit straight up 35, headed towards Dallas, and first you're going to hit San Marcos Outlet, which is about 25 minutes outside of San Antonio. You'll proceed past Austin, and right outside of Austin, you have Round Rock Outlets. You're going to go up about an hour and a half more to Hillsboro, and it's pretty much in the middle of nowhere. And there's a Nike factory store and a factory clearance store, if I'm not mistaken, that's how it's worded. You're gonna see that in some video clips in there later on in here. And I'm gonna show you what I found. But headed up this weekend, I skipped San Marcos because due to time constraints. And I just had a feeling not much was gonna be in there. So I proceeded to Round Rock, which I hadn't been in a while. It's been a few months since I went to Round Rock because I've been doing a lot of my videos in and around the greater San Antonio area. So let's get on with it and what I found at Round Rock. Found some Jordan 13 in the GGGS, and y'all know how I am. I really don't care if I like the color football right there. Really happy about what my Ravens did, moved it, pulled off. So these Jordan 13s right here, in the GG, grade school girls, if you will. And I told you, I'm not above copying some kicks for a certain colorway that I wanted. And I wanted this colorway. I thought it was really dope because of a feature on the sneaker that I'm always a fan of. I've talked about it quite a bit, and I have several sneakers with this feature on them. It's just my thing. It makes the shoe pop. Let's hit that box right there. So you got these 13s in the black, white, and anthracite. But I don't know if you're going to catch it on here, and you won't. That anthracite, which is right here on the side panel, is actually 3M coated. And when the light reflects off it properly, it glows. All right, it reflects, it's iridescent. But there's pink on there, and I rock pink. I got pink polos and stuff like that. I got some Jordan 1s with some pink in. I got some Air Force 1s with pink splashes that are men's shoes. But I'm on my Cameron thing. Pink looks good on me. Right? I'm not going to wear a whole gang of pink, but these hints right here are pretty much pink. And they already mentioned the pink in there. It says black and anthracite. So it's right there, got the nice little Jordan smooth bubble right there, the carbon fiber, dope kick right there in there. You see people, I'm looking at my Marius above me. So you see right there on the side panel. And notice my sound sounds really sharp because I'm using my studio mic that I actually use in school. It sounds much, much better, but it's sensitive. So if I bump the stand, you're gonna hear the boom. But it's got some tumblage on there. It's good stuff, so it won't crease as well as easy. But dope sneaker. Set these off to the side. And next, another pickup that I got in the GG release. Some Jordan 6s, right? Yeah, 6s. Only 6s I had prior to this, I actually have another pair, so it's gonna be 3, are the All-Star 6s that these local stores are hoping for some reason continue to sell, but you have varying prices out there, so that's what's hurting. I've seen as low as 129 and high as 180 now. But right here in the low, 6s, gray, purple, and a lime neon green, if you will, with the gel bottoms, you know, the translucent bottoms right there. All right, go kick, to him. And he's actually 8.5. And the thing about the Sixers is that the toe box is a little wider. You see it? And which means I can drop down to a 9 in the men's size. But the 8.5 works. They fit dead on. They fit perfect. Just for added comfort, I would wear a thinner sock. But my toes aren't balled up in there. I was shocked. And once I tried them on, I like the colorway. I love purple, as you can see. I love purple. I love gray sneakers too. And it just looks icy. It looks crazy, like Glacier with, you know, I slashed Barney up and threw pieces of him on there with the little Slimer from Ghostbusters. So it's just a dope sneaker, man. You know, check them out. Dope sneaker. Got to see the lace ties right down the front. A lot of people leave those down there. A lot of people leave them down there just for styling. I might. It depends how lazy I'm being. But they fit great. They're actually comfortable. So I got those. And as always, with the GG GS series, they come with the Jumpman sticker. Right, so I set these off to the side. Then I finally made it to Hillsboro. On the way up, and I cop these. I think it was on the way up. What was it when I came back? Let me look. I bought so many sneakers, it's ridiculous. Yeah, this was Saturday. This was Saturday, so I actually copped these on Saturday. No, these were yesterday. I got these. In a low, and these are sixes with the fuchsia. Alright, white sport black, the fuchsia. You got some nubuck right here. This is not suede. Okay, you should get a deep shot of that. That's not suede, that's nubuck. Okay. Got some nice tumblage going on here, and these are 9 use, and that's why I'm not a big guy, in case you're all wondering. I know y'all saw the video with the tank top on and everything. I'm 5'7", and I wear normally a size 9 male shoe, but the 9 use shoe is just a little narrow. It's pretty much the same shoe, and I can fit into there, and they release 9s in youth shoes. So if I don't find my particular size, I just look for the youth size. And a lot of times I've been pretty lucky. But it's just Foot Locker where I may not catch those at sometimes. I get lucky from time to time. But I lucked out with these, and these look fresh. I like fuchsia, believe it or not. I like fuchsia. I like the bright colors you can see with any other kicks I have. That's why the GG releases, they appeal to me. A lot of people don't like them. And something I noticed right here, of course, it's an outlet, and I'm gonna talk about the Hillsboro outlet for a second once I'm done with the shoe. If you look closely, these are B grades, hands down. This is one of the sneakers I clearly can see why these made it to this store, and maybe you can see it too. You see right there in the toe box, all right? Right there in the toe box, you see it. See the creasing? See that? And you gotta get close to see that, along with the glue splash. I'm not really worried about the glue splash, but that creasing right there is noticeable once you get close to the shoe, but most people wouldn't catch that from a distance. And these were $69.99. I get 10% off. And you know, just dope sneaker. Dope sneaker. Like them. Sneaker ties at the bottom. Yeah, dope. I like them. Alright, one thing, if I'm not mistaken, right here in this pattern, it's like a hidden thing. This is actually the 2-3 in here. I looked that up, and you can actually see the 3. Yeah. You look a little different when you see the 2. Check that out. That was something they talked about in the Secrets of the Door, when they put messages in. That's pretty cool. Alright, if you look that up, it's on Complex. A lot of people don't like Complex. Next is, I was competing, and somebody I know, they got, hope you didn't see the shoe. They actually found some bread loaves. Jordan 1 bread loaves. Actual bread loaves. And I wound up finding a nice little gem too. But these are not the bread loaves right there. You said they're 8.5, and I can fit these. I was shocked that I didn't fit these. That was gonna buy them anyway. They were at $95, and I'm gonna show you why these aren't the bread loaves. hoping my camera's much better. I know you all, but man, you look sharp on here. I have a better camera. Spent a little. Actually, I got to steal my camera, but it looks great. But right there, you can see that is not leather on the toe box. That's actually nylon, the silk pattern. And on the side, it's nylon as well in the black. But everything, the red is leather. You got toe cap. It's black leather. All right, you see right there. With the Jumpman on the tongue. Air Jordan wings on the back. So, red colorway, but not an exact red look. It's kind of like the mids that I have. That, with the crease right there, I was telling you all about it. I got wet. I wasn't paying attention because I got a little price. But these are not exact braids. It's a red colorway. So, got these for steel. You saw the price I flashed on here. $49.99. 10% off. Dope. So I was a little upset. And they found the braids in their size. The bread loads. And I got these. So, Dope. Steel action. And what was crazy was they had some shadows, the gray and black shadow ones. And I asked the guy, do you have the braids in my size? And I said, you're hearing the video. But before then, I asked him about at least an 8.5. You don't hear that part of the video because I'm at the edit. Due to people walking back and forth by the camera. But I asked him, do you have an 8.5? Just being curious. And they had them, but he didn't send the person back there to look. He was trying to sell the shadow. On my way back, hit up Round Rock and another GG release, $39.99. This is actually San Marcos. I actually stopped in San Marcos, and I was about to just say I took an L, but I went down to the GG side and found the Pure Platinums. This is GG though, alright, but I saw, I think it's the 11 LEs that are being released, and I think they're only grade school as well, with this reptilian pattern, but I like the sheen on it. Hopefully you can see that. Alright, this camera's much better. I got some shadowing going on here, but these are Pure Platinums from the GG. And I was shocked they called me the Pure Platinum, but it's the run-up they're doing for the summer and the spring. Yeah, Air Jordan 1, Return, High, Premium, XCGG, retail for $140. All right, so you know it's a premium line. White on white and Pure Platinum. Let's see if y'all can read that. Nine youth again. I was a little curious if these would be a little snug, but these are dead on. Once I loosen up the laces right here around the back end of the toe box, these were dead on. They fit me great. One cool feature I saw, and I'm gonna have to protect it as well, you know, depending on what the jeans I mentioned earlier, is the interior, sans the tongue, that's without the tongue. It's actually leather, right around the heel. That's leather in there, alright, so it feels great. Not sure how it's going to feel, it's pretty warm outside, but this fits dead on. It's a dope kick, and you know I love that gel sole, just like the black and gold GG Jordan 1s I found back home from Shoe City Outlet, and of course the new loves that I just got as a closet gift. You know, I love that gel translucent sole. It just looks dope. It looks like you're walking on water or something. It looks great. I love this gel gum translucent sole, whatever you want to call it. But the leather's good. Slightly tumbled, but this reptilian sheen. I wish you could see this. It's got like that sheen when there's oil on top of the water. It looks like that when you get close. Hopefully you can see it. It just looks like white. But yeah, the lighting is not doing it justice. But this kick looks dope, and I told you I have no issues. I'm gonna rock these, and nobody's gonna say a word to me because it's my money. I bought them. I like them. Alright? So that concludes my I-35 Hillsboro Round Rock and San Marcos Nike Outlet pickup. And closing out, I said I was going to talk about the Hillsboro Outlet. It is a Nike factory clearance store. There are no prominent displays focused on the shelving. There's no shelving, it's all racks. Like the back wall you see in the normal Nike outlet, the entire store is like that. And you really gotta have some patience in there and dedicate some time. So, being that I was passed along there, I had some time constraints on my way up because I was headed to an event along with some other things. I could not really spend a lot of time in there going up. But coming back, it was the first place I came across. It's about an hour and a half outside of Fort Worth, Arlington area. You gotta comb through it, trust me. Especially if you're somebody like me that can wear 8.5, 9 in the U-shoe or 9.5 in the U-shoe. Just keep looking. Also look in the women's side because they might have the women's size and it's the exact same shoe and you pay a little bit less. So that's one of the benefits of having this small foot. Believe it or not, my arches fell. I wear 8.5. And I could really, really get some steals in. But just dope pickups for the low. I think I spent no more than $230 in the 5 pairs of sneakers that I got here. So running back, you got the Jordan 6 in the gray and purple. You got the 13s in the black, anthracite, and pink that they do not mention the pink. Dope is a steal. And you got the kind of sort of breads. Alright? The kind of sort of breads. Alright? Some people will look at these like, oh, the breads. I'm going to talk now about the breads because you see the nylon right there. Close enough on the steal. Alright? But legit came from a Nike store. And it was the last. You got another pair of sixes in the black, in gym black as they called it, and white with the tumblers and the fuchsia right here. Dope sneaker, dope. And probably the steal of the day right here, the white GG Pure Platinums. And I said I'm gonna rock these, and most people don't know enough about sneakers to go, man, these are girl sneakers. Dude, I'm gonna wear these, all right? My feet are small enough, I like the colorway, and I'm a grown ass man, all right? Love them. So once again, as you can see, it's not about how much you paid for them, because I paid for the love. Why did you pay that much? Right. And I'm out of here. Boom. My nigga, what up, family? My nigga, what up, fam? In a lamb.